Incoming Western Australian Premier Roger Cook has thrown his support behind the Indigenous Voice to Parliament. Our reporter Crystal Wu is at Parliament House for us. Crystal, talk us through the main outcomes from his speech yesterday.
Well, Tom, as you mentioned before, Roger Cook does support the Indigenous Voice to Parliament. He claims he will continue to fight for WA's fair share of the GST deal, and he does have the energy to lead WA. Those were the main outcomes from his first press conference as the incoming Premier alongside his incoming Deputy Rita Saffiotti. Now, Roger Cook has had a long association with the Aboriginal community. He said he wanted to get into politics to fight the injustice and racism here in Australia.
I've said many times that the measure of any society is the way it treats its most disadvantaged and defenceless. I'll be front and centre of the Voice campaign in Western Australia. It's not just important for WA, it's important for the nation. This is an historical moment for everyone in this nation to stand up and do the right thing.
Roger Cook was the last man standing in the race for the top job. He delivered the speech alongside his deputy, Rita Saffiotti, and the pair claimed they will continue to remain united as a team, as the WA Labor team, to lead the state. But that wasn't the case on Tuesday morning when Health Minister Amber Jade Sanderson announced she had been selected by the left faction of the Labor Party to be in the contest. Hours after that, she decided to withdraw from the contest in the interest of unity and stability in the Labor Party. Roger Cook and Rita Saffiotti claim they will remain united, and they claim they will have the grit, like Premier Mark McGowan did, to continue to fight for WA's fair share of its 70 cents to $1 GST deal.
I'll fight tooth and nail for WA's fair share of the GST. It's important that any West Australian leader stands up for this state, and I'll be head and shoulders in that process.
Tom, Mark McGowan resigned because he was tired. He said he didn't have enough energy to lead the nation. One of the key questions pressed to Cook during the press conference yesterday was, how are your energy levels? Can you lead the nation? Do you have enough energy to lead the nation? To which he answered yes. He's been the Deputy Premier for 11 years, and he is ready to lead WA, Tom.